Welcome to Biz Alchemy, a podcast about creating a new business paradigm by women for women. I'm your alchemical host, Jacquelyn Atkins, and I'm going to take you on an extraordinary adventure to create a business filled with ease, fun, spaciousness, and abundance. Hustle, be gone. Let's birth a new way. Welcome back. Today, I am going to share with you the five most common blocks that I see in the heart chakra of businesses. Now, the heart chakra is the fourth chakra. It's the central chakra because there are three chakras below and there are three chakras above, major chakras, that is. So it's the central chakra where the physical and the spiritual come together. The color of the heart chakra is green, although often pink is used to portray the heart chakra as well. Pink tends to be related to the higher heart. But when I'm looking at it visually, I will often see a mix of green and pink. And certainly if I'm doing some sort of clearing on the heart, often a pink energy comes through, this higher vibration of the heart. It sort of is the energy that I see sitting between the heart and the throat chakra. That's where the pink comes in. Now, obviously, most people would associate love with the heart chakra. And certainly it is the chakra of love. It is the chakra of compassion. And a business's heart chakra is connected to these energies. But for me, what I'm really seeing when I have a look in the heart chakra of clients and of their businesses is that the heart chakra is about your authentic self. I see that this is where the essence of you resides, or the essence of your business resides, the truth of you, without all the filters, without the facades and the masks and all the conditioning and the roles you take on. Strip that back, and that light in the center is your authentic self. And that's what I see is such a foundational part of the heart chakra. So a balanced heart chakra allows you to be who you are instead of molding yourself to external expectations. And it's exactly the same for your business's heart. So the more you allow the real you into your relationships, the more you are authentic, you know, the less you have to hide or filter or mask, the more that you will attract in people who resonate with the true you and not resonate with a version of you. And in many ways, isn't this like an ongoing journey in our life? This is what we're here to do. It's almost like we come in as this authentic being, and then we just have all these veils put over us through our being raised by our parents, through our schooling, through our society, through the employers. It's all around us all the time. Put on this mask, put on this veil. And then we spend the remainder of our life pulling those off, finding that authentic flame within you. And your business is much the same. It takes on all of these expectations, external expectations, which masks its true heart energy. And so for you to really attract in the people and the resources that you want to receive into your life and into your business, it's vital that you are constantly on this journey to authenticity, and that you also allow your business to really get back to its authentic essence. And let's face it, this can actually be harder than it sounds. Just when you think, yeah, I'm being fully authentic here, a situation will come up where you find, oh, I feel like I need to pull that back. I can't express that. I can't share that part of myself. Oh my gosh, what are they going to think about that? And you suddenly find yourself almost like manipulating the energy you're putting out to almost protect. It feels like a protection often, to protect yourself from what you perceive others may think or how they might react to that truth of you. It's an ongoing journey to really own that truth and to feel strong and empowered and engage the solar plexus energy to be strong in that truth. And another aspect of the heart chakra that I want to touch on here, which is so important, is the balance of giving and receiving. And this is, again, in your energy body as well as for your business. That the heart chakra is so similar in the heart chakra of the client and the heart chakra of the business. They really represents the same energies. And I'll explore this more when I go through the five common blocks. So let's start with that now. So the first common block I see in a business's heart chakra, I've already talked a little bit about this, but it's about your business not being authentic. And this happens purely because we want our business to be successful. And so we look to others who have successful businesses to find out what their formula is, how they attract their clients, how the businesses are run, the strategy in place, and we adapt that to our business. But what can happen in that process is that we lose the heart of our business. We lose its authenticity, why it was birthed in the first place. And we suddenly end up on a very different path to the path that our business's heart really wants to go on. This is so easy to do. We realize that this has happened when we suddenly no longer feel joy or no longer feel inspired by our business. Because while ever you are following its authenticity, following the heart of the business, you will feel joy and inspiration. And when that goes, it's because the heart has come out of it. It's because you have really overstepped the boundary by adopting others' strategies or plans or visions for your business instead of following your heart, instead of following your business's heart and doing it your way. I cannot tell you how many business heart chakras I've looked at where it's almost like there's a sadness in the business's heart because it's so far off its path, because the owner of the business has followed so many different mentors in their craving to have a successful business and to have a successful business fast, and in giving those mentors more power than what they themselves are holding when it comes to choices about their business. And the business's heart chakra just ends up depleted because it's not the right strategy for it. It's not the right vision for it. It's completely out of alignment with its authentic essence. And so no wonder that business is attracting the wrong clients or no clients. It's just because the heart has gone out of the business, the passion. The business isn't feeling the passion, and you pick up on that, or you, the entrepreneur, the owner, picks up on that because they're no longer feeling passionate. As I said, the joy and the inspiration has gone. And so in many ways, it does become heartless. It becomes devoid of heart. And that's purely because it's lost touch with its authentic self. So I hope this helps you realize the importance of staying true to the authenticity of your business, of being able to take the input of others and put it through your own filters so that your business can stay true to its essence. And to realize how mimicking others is not supporting the heart chakra of your business. So number two, this is a big one. And this is the imbalance of giving and receiving. Now, I have done a podcast on this before, and that's episode 13, Receiving the Biggest Lesson from Your Business, or Receiving, the biggest lesson from your business. So I'll just cover it briefly today. And for a more in-depth exploration, you can go and listen to that episode. But as I talk about then, I usually see the receiving aspect of the heart chakra as the back of the heart chakra and the giving as the front. And when I look at a business, and indeed when I look at the business owner, very often the front of the heart is much more open. There is a lot more giving going on than receiving. And this creates an imbalance. It means the business is often giving from a depleted place, like the entrepreneur, and this affects the vibration of the energy that you are putting out and that your business is putting out. And so receiving is vital. I mean, it's a business. It has to receive. It has to receive money to make it a business. And so even if you're at the beginning stages of your business and you're not receiving money, you're still giving free sessions, please make sure you're receiving something in exchange. You're receiving a testimonial or just some sort of exchange so that the energy is working both ways. Energy is flow, and it has to flow in and it has to flow out. And ideally that flow in and out is equal. Now, in the case of a business, ideally the flow in is a little more so that the business is actually profitable. In my early days when I was offering free 15-minute throat chakra clearings, I would always ask my clients for a testimonial in exchange or for a review on Google or Facebook in exchange for that. Now, not everyone gave that, but at least I was giving them an opportunity for an energetic exchange. And this is really important. This was an honoring of my business, and it was also an honoring of my time. That was important for my receiving as well. So as I said, go back and listen to episode 13 and I'll explore that much more deeply. So block number three, and this is so common, when a niche is created from the mind and not the heart. And the reason this is so common is because very often when you are establishing your business and you are working in a program of some sort to help you get that business established, you are told you must have a niche. Just create a niche. And even if later on you change the niche, you have to create it now because you have to know who you're speaking with or who you're speaking to. And yeah, that makes sense. You do. I wholeheartedly agree with that. However, you cannot let the mind create the niche. And very often, that's where it ends up being created from. The niche has to come from your heart chakra, from the heart chakra of your business. This is the passion. This is why your business is there. This is who it wants to speak to. The niche, that audience, is usually an audience that you can relate to because you have experience in that. Or for some reason, you just feel so passionate about it. It's just driving you. And it's just like, these are the people I really want to make a difference in their lives, talking with them about this. You know, your niche is something you love to talk about. You can just get on live and just talk about it. You can write some copy about it. You love it. It inspires you. It brings you joy. You can't stop talking about it. That doesn't come from your mind. That comes from your heart, and that is an integral part of your business's heart. And I often see a business's heart chakra clogged up and almost overridden by the third eye, by the mind aspect of the third eye, because the entrepreneur's gone, I have to create a niche, and they've thought it through and they've not connected in with the business's heart. They've not connected in with the reason that business was birthed in the first place. That's where the niche lies. Now, block number four is going back to the original energy of the heart that I mentioned at the beginning, love. And I will also see blocks in a business's heart when it's not feeling loved by you, when it's not feeling appreciated by you. And this can often happen, especially if our business isn't necessarily going in the direction we hoped, achieving what we'd hoped. And we can become maybe a little bit resentful or a little bit bitter or a bit angry with it, a bit frustrated with it. And we actually forget to share with our business that we love it. It's an entity. Its heart chakra thrives on your gratitude, on your appreciation. And it's a beautiful thing to do, to just stop now and again and feel gratitude for what your business has brought you. And that doesn't have to be just income. That can be the connections, the new people it's brought to you. That can be the personal evolution that you've gone through as a result of having the business. It can be new skills that it's taught you. There is so much that your business gifts you with beyond the financial. So take time to really honor your business. Something beautiful to do to really tap into that is to write a love letter to your business and just tell it how you love it, and why you love it. And this is very powerful in activating the heart chakra of your business. So make it feel wanted, just like you would to any other person in a relationship with you. Well, to nurture the relationship, that's what you would do. If the relationship isn't going so well, maybe it's because you haven't been doing that as well. So it's just like having a relationship with someone. I really love to take that time now and again to honor what my business has brought to my life. And if you think back to before you started your business and where you're at, and then think about where you're at now, and to just think about the expansion in so many different facets of your life as a result of your business, that immediately opens your heart chakra and fills you with so much gratitude. So I really encourage that you do this regularly. The fifth one is quite an interesting one, and it is connected with the sacral chakra. It's an element of your business feeling alone, like it's doing it on its own. And this can happen if it's an online business, for example, or it can also happen if you are not surrounding yourself with a tribe that really uplifts you, uplifts your vibration, uplifts your business's vibration, that helps your business grow in its vibration. And if it's not surrounded by clients who also help it grow in its vibration, if it has clients that are bringing its energy down. As I said, this is very linked to the sacral chakra, but loneliness is a part of the heart chakra. And it's not just you that can feel lonely. Your business on its own can feel lonely. And that's why a mastermind of like-minded businesses can be really important. Businesses at a similar vibration to your business. Businesses who have a similar vision to your business. I don't mean that in terms of like the same thing, going for the same thing, but in terms of the vibration of it and what it's there to achieve. This is actually really supportive of the business's heart chakra. And that loneliness can also come from the fact that you are not communicating with your business. So your business feels estranged from you. So again, just connecting regularly with your business will really help shift that energy of loneliness in your business. So that's all I have for today on the heart chakra of your business. I hope that you've had a few light bulbs go off there and recognize some ways that you can help your business to open and activate its heart chakra more. And next week, I will be sharing with you a meditation to help activate or clear and activate your heart chakra and your business's heart chakra. So maybe in the week in between, you can have a think about what I've been suggesting and maybe start to make a few changes to help clear and open your business's heart chakra. And then next week, I'll bring through the meditation for you to really work on opening and activating the heart chakra. Because as you can tell from what I've talked about, this is vital in attracting the right people into your business, whether that's the right clients or the right support people. It's vital that the heart is authentic, open, ready to receive, and connected between you and your business. And I also have a beautiful opportunity for you to connect further with your business and to clear out the energy of your business and reset it for the season ahead. And this is a solstice retreat, a mini retreat because it's a 2-hour retreat that I'm offering on Monday, June 21st to celebrate the solstice, to celebrate the shift in seasons. And during this retreat, we will be coming together, performing a beautiful ritual and honoring of our businesses, connecting in with our business, clearing and letting go of anything that doesn't serve us. We will have released a lot through this current eclipse period anyway, and we will emerge through the eclipses to the portal of the solstice. And at that moment, it's a perfect opportunity to align to the path that lies ahead for the next season. It's going to be very powerful. I can feel the energies coming in. They're very new energies that I haven't channeled through before. And I'm going to bring them through for you and for your business during this retreat. Now, so I can capture my audience all over the world, I'm offering the retreat at two different times. The first one is at 10 a.m. Australian Eastern Standard Time. Now, this won't suit you so well if you're in Europe, but if you are in North America, South America, it will be 8 p.m. on Sunday, the 20th of June. So this is happening just a few hours ahead of the solstice. The second retreat is at 6 p.m. Australian Eastern Standard Time on Monday, the 21st, which is 9 a.m. British Summer Time on Monday, the 21st. So I would love you to be able to join me for one of those times. The retreat will go for around 2 hours, like it really is a mini retreat, but it's vital that you switch off from your regular life and really allow yourself to drop into the retreat space. Now, this retreat is US $11. I've made it very affordable. I have made it so that there is some exchange, but I want as many people as possible to be able to share in the magic of the energies, the alchemy of the energies that are going to be coming through. So I do hope you can join me. There will be a recording if you can't be live. However, if you are live, you will get a little channeled message through. I'm going to go around to each person and channel. I don't know what it'll be, whether it'll be a word or a phrase, but it will be something to activate you for the season ahead. So that's a bonus if you're able to make it live. So if you are interested, go to my website, jacquelynatkins.com, and you'll see it right there on the homepage. You can just click the link and sign up for the retreat. Choose which time you'll be at, and I look forward to sharing this experience with you. Thanks for listening today and wishing you an alchemical week in your biz. Thanks for listening to Biz Alchemy. I'm Jacquelyn Atkins. If you'd love to know more about the energy of business, join me on Insight Timer, where I have a large meditation library and do regular live meditations. Or visit my website, jacquelynatkins.com. Until next time, enjoy creating alchemy in your biz.